afternoon, everyone. This is Kevin Gianni from the Renegade Health Show, and today is Tuesday. We are here at Owl Creek Pass, which is right outside of Ridgeway, Colorado. It's actually pretty far outside of Ridgeway. We just took a really long drive. But look at this. I mean, this is just absolutely amazing. Look at these mountains. The aspens here. I love the color of the aspens. The aspens are starting to turn right now, and it's absolutely incredible when they turn gold. So just enjoy it. We're going to answer some of your questions today. So here we are. We're not in that beautiful scenery anymore. We spent the whole day there, and that's why this video is a little bit late, because we were out hiking, and we have some amazing pictures. We'll post them on Flickr eventually, flickr.com, flickr.com/Kevin Gianni. You can see all our pictures that we've ever taken up to, when was the last time we uploaded them, Anne-Marie?
I know we uploaded Peru.
Peru. So you can see the Peru pictures.
I don't know if we did after that.
Yeah, and everything else that we take over time. So you can check that out if you want. But let's get into your question. So first question here is, Veronica says, what studies have Dr. Stanley Bass done that are actually published? And this was in response to Susan Shank talking about Stanley Bass. All right, so here's the thing. It's a good question, though it's a question that I don't know if we need to be focusing on. And here's why. Because of the bureaucracy that's... What is he doing? Get out of there.
He's trying to get water out of the...
Hey, buddy.
the glass jar.
It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter where the... It doesn't matter where the water is. He won't drink it out of his container. He'll just drink it out of any other place. It's amazing. Yeah. A lot of animals actually do that, and he's just one of them. So anyway, I think asking that question might be going the wrong route, because there's a lot of bureaucracy when it comes to published studies. So that's very important. And there's also a lot of industry involved in published studies. So there can be some very valid and well-done studies, either with people who have done their own scientific research or people who have done clinical studies with their own patients, and that may never have been published. And some of those might be extremely valid. So I don't know if this is the end all in terms of, you know, whether a study is good or not, or whether someone should be credible or not either. So as far as I know, I don't know any of the studies that Stanley Bash has published, but he's done some research that I think is valuable to some degree. And many people have done research, and a lot of people that we quote in terms of experts, they don't have published studies either. And, you know, they're putting out great information too, and we're listening to that. So why are we questioning Dr. Stanley Bass? So, you know, I'm not being confrontational here. I'm just trying to open up our minds to the whole picture. We can't be looking at published studies. We can't be looking at all the journals all the time. We have to be very very conscious and very skeptical of the information that's coming to us at all times. We can't be looking in the media. You know, we have to be very careful when we're looking in our magazines, listening on the radio, watching TV. Because this information is not full. It's not full information. I mean, we have to do a daily show at Monday through Friday in order to get at least just a tidbit of or a small piece of the entire puzzle. And we keep doing it because I feel that I haven't covered everything yet. So if you hear something on TV that's like 30 seconds long, oh my gosh. It's not the whole picture. So anyway, let's get into some more stuff here. This is probably another whole picture stuff. D asks, fish oil. What about the mercury levels? Shouldn't they be consumed in moderation? And doesn't mercury affect brain function along with the nervous system? Mercury does affect brain function. It does affect the nervous system as well. What about mercury levels in fish oil? If you choose to take fish oil, there are companies that do produce and test their fish oil. I know Carlson's is one. Nordic Naturals is another. And Sohn's, S-O-N-N-E, Sohn. I think it's just Sohn, because when I was taking fish oil back in Connecticut, we used to take that product, and I remember contacting them and asking them about their testing. So people do test for mercury levels in their fish oil. You just need to go to the right place. You need to make sure you're going to the right people. And there's always people doing good things when it comes out. You just got to ask around. You got to figure out which ones are the right ones or not. That's if you choose to do fish oil. All right, reciprocity foods. I've not considered doing raw rice milk. Would sprouting it be even more beneficial? Sure, sprouting it would be great. Just let it soak in some water, and some rice sprouts, and some rice doesn't visibly sprout at all. So, you know, it's just soaking it would be beneficial, period. So let it soak a little bit. That's helpful. Let's see. All right, Greg ask, I was wondering if you had any knowledge about the claims made for the health benefits of rooibos tea. Many thanks. I have so much trouble pronouncing that. Every single time I can't get it right. But anyway, so here's the benefits of this type of tea are increased hydration, as far as I've done with just the small amount of conversation I've had with other people. Is it going to save your life? Like, you know, eating healthy and exercising and managing your stress and sleeping well and liking your job, finding your passion, liking your relationships. I'm going to put that a second to all those. Just like many of the other foods, many of the other superfoods that you hear about, you know, really, you know, managing those six things that I mentioned is going to be the most important focus for everyone. So, you know, does it make sense to add some of these great foods into your diet? Absolutely. Does it make sense to really work on the big things first? Oh, yeah. And that's really what the whole message is here. It's not a message about, you know, what little food's going to get you X, Y, or Z. It's about how you can make your life phenomenal, and then the health comes with it. So I'm going to leave it at that. Your question of the day is this. Have you ever been to Colorado? Go ahead and post it down below. This is Kevin Gianni from the Renegade Health Show. Together we can change the health of the world, one show at a time.